PA Victor and its dealers present Burr Tilstrom, creator of Kukla, Ollie, and all the Kuklapolitan players, with Fran Allison in Kukla, Fran, and Ollie.
Good evening, television friends and friends of television. I am more than delighted to be here to make this announcement tonight because, as your host, Colonel Crackie, I believe that I have an announcement of great import and export to you all. I believe that tonight will mark again another milestone in television and television programming for the American home. And so, therefore, it gives me a great deal. Look who's telling me to hurry. Fletcher Rabbit. Gives me a great deal of pleasure. I will not hurry. I will take my time. Down where I come from, we do not hurry. Unnecessarily. He left. I would like to tell you that tonight marks this particular a milestone because tonight we are offering, the Kuklapolitan players, all of us here, are offering to you a very remarkable service. We are going to offer for the first time on the air a really educational program that I think you're going to enjoy. We came to this conclusion, I will not hurry. Beg your pardon. We came to this conclusion. I beg your pardon a moment. You did that on purpose. You did so. Don't tell me it was a slip. Let's not have another slip like that. I'll beg your pardon. Oh, there's no business like show business. So, I was about to say, last night there was a hurried emergency, emergency meeting of the Kuklapolitan Board of Directors, which consists of all of us, and it was voted at that time that there was should be something done for the leisure time of the different players, and in the discussion we decided that perhaps it would be a very interesting thing if everyone made better use of their leisure time. I firmly believe in the development of crafts and hobbies, model making, and working with your hands. In general, it's a great thing. It's a wonderful thing to be able to create something. Whether it be a souffle or a palace built of toothpicks. It's a grand, glorious thing and a great thing for all your ologies and your isms. If you have them. I quite frankly confess I do not have them. All right. And so it was voted last night that our good friend, Mr. Fletcher Rabbit, be approved chairman of the hobby department or the president of the Kuklapolitan Associated Arts and Creative Craft and better use of the leisure time for people who have it, Blues Society. I believe that was the title. And he is the chairman, and he's going to take over from now. This is to inaugurate a new series on our show of educational programs entitled Hobbies for Everyone, Hobbies for You, Hobbies for Me in Hobbies. So now I'd like to introduce to you, and I hope you'll all give him a rousing hand, your good friend, our chairman, Fletcher Rabbit.
Thank you, Colonel Crackie. And thank you. That's enough, thank you. Thank you. Isn't he long-winded? Gracious. Thank you, television friends. Well, I certainly think this is grand to be with you all. Here we are. All hello, you fellow hobbyists and craft modelers. It certainly... Aren't we going to have fun tonight working with wood and various kinds of materials. Aren't we? Well, we certainly are. You bet. Well, tonight we have many surprises for you, and we're going to show you how to do many things in your own home which will help you. So first of all, just to prove that, of course, we here at the Kuklapolitan Hobby Club are just all one grand family and feel that the little woman, if you'll excuse the expression, should have just as much fun and part in this leisure time activities as a little man, why, we are going to ask a young lady to come up here and speak to you on a subject that is very dear to her heart and to ours, too, hobbies. Miss Frances Allison, let's give her a lovely hand before we get into the evening's program. Come on. Thank you. Miss Allison.
What?
Miss Allison. Fran, you're supposed to speak.
Oh, my speech.
Yes.
Thank you.
Do you want
Mr.
me to
Chairman,
say?
You needn't. Well, I really am very unaccustomed to public speaking, but I have rallied to the cause and will give you the ideas I have on this subject. My subject tonight is hubbies. Now, many of you may refer to this particular class as husbands, but we have a sort of little slogan. We thought, let's be clubby and call them hubbies. Now, this, of course, is a class... What's the matter?
No, the wrong subject, Fran. Hobbies.
Oh, heavens, I thought you said hubby. Excuse me.
Well, thank you, Miss Alice. Now, we will hear, I'm going to retire for a few moments to get the materials ready for our class demonstration tonight, and I'm going to invite two of our enthusiastic hobbyists up here on the stage to work with you and talk to you about hobbies and what they mean to people, and hobbies can be props. Hobbies, excuse me.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Hello, fellow hobbyists. Well, tonight really does inaugurate a new program. And we certainly, what's the matter?
You don't really mean this, do you?
I can't help it. Fletcher is so enthusiastic and we voted it.
I know. I lost my head.
You voted like everybody else.
That's what I said. Lost my head.
Well, let's get into it.
Okay. Hello. Hello, Kukla, my fellow worker boy. It's certainly nice to see you here in the craft shop tonight. We're going to build some real fine things, aren't we?
You bet. Where are the clothespins? We're going to make clothespin dolls tonight.
Not me.
Come here. What is your hobby, fellow?
My hobby, fellow, is poetry. And I just made up a little poem as I came over today. This fits in, Cooper.
Okay.
let's see. When I woke up early this morn, and thought of Kukla, Fran, and Holiday, I found an article by Harriet Van Horn in this month's issue of Holiday. Coop, I couldn't help it. I had to get it.
Never mind, now. It's true. It really is. Let's see where it is.
Here's the issue of Holiday. This is a new Holiday magazine. It just came out. Well, it just came out here in the East. Probably be out a month in the West by the time you get it, but it's new here. Oh, this is great. Oh, there's a picture. Look.
There we are. Isn't that wonderful?
Well, it's a nice article, too, Coop. You'll excuse me. I think I'll go down and read it. I didn't want to work with hobbies.
Wait, but you're supposed to show the relationship of hobbies here.
Well, am I?
Yes.
A holiday magazine is not a hobby.
I know it isn't.
Oh, I know. Once upon a time, there was a little girl who liked to write. She liked to write very much, so she made a hobby of writing. And now... her hobby has proved profitable. And her name is Harriet Van Horn.
Well, I hope you all see the article anyway. It's in the new Holiday that just came out. It's very wonderful. And we liked it anyway. Well, my mother's calling me.
Thank you very much. That certainly was a rousing speech and should get us off to a grand start. Well, before we begin with the hobby of the evening, let's again hear from Miss Allison, because I'm sure she has problems just as well as the rest of us about that a hobby could solve. And so let us speak now to Fran Allison.
What was it you wanted to know, Fran?
I wanted to know about, hobbies.
Well, hobbies,
can I help you?
Well, as a matter of fact, you could.
Oh?
Because, as you know, I have one hobby, which is listening to music. You know
yes.
how I've enjoyed my little fort. Wait, I think I should have everything to really show you what a wonderful... Just a second.
Certainly. I knew this would happen. And this will give us a...
To show you what a wonderful thing a hobby can be.
This isn't a hobby, Francis.
This is with me.
Why, Francis, no, this is the little RCA Victor 45.
Oh, well, I know that, but I make a hobby of listening to it.
Oh,
and
that's very interesting.
I guess you know what a large collection of records I have.
Oh, yes, yes, indeed,
now,
I do.
Of course, it really isn't so much a problem to store away the little 45 records because they're so easily stored.
That's right.
But I think that the little covers of them are so attractive that I'd like to make a display. But if I only had a little shelf where I could show them...
Oh,
to
just the very thing. Certainly. You should go in our woodworking shop and work. Oh, that's just the thing.
Well, Fletcher, I'm not particularly handy at anything like that.
But this is so simple. Why, let me find out something first. Now, let me see. Do you have the, what size do you have? Do you have the 78 RPM
well,
record?
Well, I have 78. Yes, I do.
Oh, mm-hmm.
But, it's the little 45s that I'm most concerned with.
Oh, you have a place for the 78?
Yes, I have.
Oh, well, then that's really a snap. Excuse me, I just bumped into something down
there. Oh, that's all right.
Now, here, I have the little 78 RPM album.
Those are the ones which I speak.
This is the one that I love very much, too, by the way. I was just listening to this.
Boy Who Sang for the King?
Yeah, isn't that an attractive
Dennis
little,
Day?
Yeah, yes, Dennis
Wonderful.
Day.
Wonderful.
He has a lovely voice.
Oh, yes, he has
Such
indeed.
A fine young man. Do you know this has little pictures inside, too?
Yes, I know, Fletcher. Little story, you
little
see,
story,
it will follow.
Little pictures inside, mm-hmm. isn't that cute?
Yes,
isn't that
indeed.
Charming?
Certainly is.
Well, I think it is, too. Well, Francis, you have come to the right fellow.
Well,
because all you have to do is build a... you're handy with tools, no doubt.
Well, no,
certainly you are, and if you're not, you should...
If you knew a place where I could buy one...
No, no, I will not hear of you buying a little shelf, because these little RCA Victor albums are so easy to store that you can just make a very wonderful, teensy-weensy little shelf that will just look so handsome on your wall, and you can just put them all right in there. Why, it's just a snap.
Well, I'm sure it would
now,
be...
Now, the first thing you do is... Why don't you go over in the workshop?
All right.
Well, she's a little fearful now, but once she gets going, my grace, oh, say, isn't this fine, this RCA Victor 45? Huh. This is the one with all the little Wild West drawings on it. Isn't that cute? There's a cattle. And there's a 45. And there's a horse. And my, certainly fine, world's fastest record changer. Load up with 10 records. We only happen to have two on top here, but you can load up with 10. If I have a little more time, I just go get 10 and show you how they work. It's quite exciting. Kukla! Kukla! What? My whiskers are caught! Kukla! Kukla! My whiskers are caught!
I told you to shave this morning.
Why, Kukla, I never shave. Kukla!
Well, that's an interesting hobby.
No, this is not a hobby. This is serious. Kukla, please.
What did you do? Why, that's ridiculous.
My whiskers caught. I put the record down, and I neglected to tie up my whiskers when I did.
Well, that's a very interesting thing. Well, it'll be quite a hobby. It'll probably take us the rest of the evening to get you out of this.
Kukla.
All right, Fletcher, I'm sorry.
Thank you very much. Gracious sakes. I think you're going to help. Now, let's put this back in Fran's room, because...
Where's Fran?
She's working over in the woodshop. And in just a moment, we're going to take a look at it. Let's see how our little hobbyist is getting along over there. Well, there she is. Having a good time, aren't you? That's good. Well, now you're going to make the little shelf for the RCA Victor 45. That's fine. Wait a minute, Francis. Did you measure yet? Well, really. Let's measure our little albums first before we saw. You got your little albums there? That's fine. All right. Got your tape measure. Fine. Pull it out. That's a girl. All right, now measure. Got that correctly? Mm-hmm. All right, now measure the height. No, the height. That's right. Got that? Good. All right. Now you may start sawing, if you have the right measurement. Got the saw? That's good. Got plenty of nails? Oh, no, Francis. Those are not nails. Those are bolts. Nails. Is that board square? Find your T-square. No. No, Fran. It's perfectly all right. Yes, nails. That's a good girl. Well, you just go ahead. Let's come back. Fran, don't... Fran, no, you're not experienced enough for that yet. Now you just go ahead and work out your problem. We'll come back to you in just a minute. Bye. Well, that's just fine. Well, now we're going to get on with the hobby of the day, and that is clocks. You must have many old clocks around the neighborhood and around the house that you'd like to have fixed. Why, certainly, everyone does, and people like to collect clocks. Why, I had a letter just last week from a friend of mine, He's a fox, by the way. Joseph Fox, up in Milwaukee. And he said, why, I love to collect clocks and I like to repair them. And that is indeed a profitable and interesting hobby. So tonight we are going to talk about clocks. Now, I wonder how our little girl is getting along over there. Let's take a look in the shop again. Well, still has a long way to go. Well, let's come back here again now, shall we? Thank you. Well, first of all, my friend Cecil Bill... and I are going to show you how to make a clock, the simple type clock, the simplest kind of clock. Cecil Bill? Come on. Everyone knows that the simplest kind of clock in the world and the earliest kind of clock is an hourglass, don't you? Well, I'm glad you do. Well, now, this is a simple hourglass. Now, you take a... Very well. Ask Kukla to come up. My friend is not interested in hobbies. Let's take a look and see how our little girlfriend's getting along again over there, shall we? Well, isn't that too bad? Well, she'll get there. Hello over there. Well, guess she'll get... Now,
did you want me?
Oh, yes. Here, punch a hole through this. There, that is the first operation. Now, would you ask us?
What's this going to be?
An hourglass.
Oh, fine.
That's enough. Now, this is a very simple operation. Now, this is the simplest kind of timepiece to make. Now, we have it this side, you see, and now we turn it over and. There we are. Now, you can tell time by this.
How?
Well, by watching the salt. I happen to use salt. The salt, you usually use sand. It's not such a waste. But I didn't happen to have any sand. Watching by the length of
how do you time it?
Well, you look at a clock and see how long it takes to go through. And, and that is the world's simplest. Oh, how's our little girl? Well, here she is. How are you coming along, Francis? Oh, that's too bad. Not quite ready yet, huh? Well, why didn't you come in? Bring what you have and come over here. I'd like to see you for a minute. Hope she's completed. I'm sure she has. That's the way with hobbies. You get so engrossed in them, why, you just can't keep... You know, it's just a wonderful thing. Well, come on in, Francis. Well, gracious sakes, isn't that a fine thing?
Yes, if I could just figure out what it is.
Well, you go back and just think it... Oh, Francis?
Those blocks yesterday were a cinch compared to this.
Oh, well, I'm terribly sorry. was just telling the folks about clocks. We're working on clocks. We're working on them, repairing them, and helping. Now, this, for instance, here's a thing that I've been working on for a long time. It's the clock.
Well, say, I'm so glad you told me.
Isn't that nice? Do you know anything about clocks?
Not one thing.
Not a thing? Oh, I'm sure you know something about
clocks. No, I don't really know much about them. I'm never quite sure whether they're working right or not, because I don't even know too well what time it is.
Oh, really?
Well, I do now, but I didn't.
Oh?
I didn't know what time it was. Then I met you. Oh, what a lovely time it was. How sublime it was, too. I didn't know what day it was. You held my hand, warm as the month of May it was. And I'll say it was grand, grand to be alive, to be young, to be mad, to be yours alone. Grand to see your face, feel your touch, hear your voice say, you're all my own. I didn't know what year it was. Life was no prize. I wanted love, and there it was, shining out of your eyes. I'm wise, and I know what time it is now.
Well, say, that's a hobby in itself, gracious sakes. Well, Fran, you just don't have to work anymore now today, I tell you.
Thank you,
sir. Clock fixers and clock collectors have a grand ceremony that they call synchronization. And I'm sure that you must have a clock at home that you could bring in, perhaps in your room, that you could bring in, and we'll have what we call the synchronization time. Don't you think that would be fun?
Oh, I'd love to be a part of that.
You just go ahead and get your clock, and in the meantime, I'm going to work on something special for
all
you.
All right, Fletcher.
Now, for instance, clock lovers. It's a simple thing to repair a clock. Gracious sakes. Now, I've been working on this clock. Obviously, there's something wrong with it. It doesn't work. Therefore, you knock it around a couple of times like that first. Well, if you still hear no tick, then you decide, well, there is something wrong. So you get yourself a hammer, and you give it a couple of jolts, like that. Well, or more like... Look!
I got it, Fletch.
Well, I'm glad. I'm glad. Oh. Well, there is some life in it, obviously. So let's see what the inside is like. My gracious, that is an exciting thing, the inside of a clock. Have you ever seen it? Have you?
No.
Well, don't you want to see?
No.
You must see this. This is a grand hobby. Now, the first thing to do, of course, you find the little bolts around here, get them loose, and then you take the little handle and you... Well, gracious, goodness gracious me, there was something wrong with this clock, wasn't there? Well, that will take a bit of repairing, I'm afraid. How interesting. Well, down the top. Well, now, I have an interesting clock I want you... Well, let's all bring our clocks in, shall we? Francis, do you have your clock?
I'm getting it.
Well, that's good. Now... Here's a fine old antique clock that I've been working on for a long time. Now, I'm going to... Miss Allison, here's a collector's item I want you to see. I'll turn this a little bit. That's fine. Is that better, boys? That's fine.
Can I see it from here?
Oh, if you like, yes. I'm just getting things ready here.
All right.
Here's an old-fashioned cuckoo clock that I happened to pick up in my wandering recently. And there we are. There, and we'll get this cuckoo clock. But this is a real antique. The only thing is I've never been able to open it and make it work. But perhaps tonight we can just have it here just for good luck. Now, let me see. Any more clocks? Did you bring your clock yet, miss?
Yes, I have it.
Would you mind bringing it in, please?
No.
All right.
It's mine.
That's fine.
Should I put it up here?
Yes. Now, everyone synchronize your watches and clocks, because this is the time when we have them all go at once. Are we all set now?
Yes.
This is a grand fun. We call this Jubilee time. Well, how about it, kids? Shall we go?
Yes.
Well, I'll get this fixed back here, and we'll start it. And it... Oh, there we start. There we go.
At the start of the next time, she will be
56.
At the start of the next time, she will be 26 and a half feet. At the start of the next round, it will be 626 and a half feet. At the start of the next round, at the start of the next round, it will be 626 and a half feet.
Where did you come from, Miss Coocoo?
Hello, darling.
Hello.
Oh, it's so wonderful to see you all again. Well, I never had such a royal welcome in all my life. When I heard all that noise, I just had to come out and say hello to you.
Well, we're so glad you came. How can you say?
Darling, I just fine horse, my sweet dear Oliver.
Well, Ollie, I don't believe Ollie is with us.
Did you call me your friend?
Oliver, darling, it's been so many years since I've seen you.
Clara Coocoo.
I try.
My goose is cooked.
Well, what did he mean?
He's not been well lately.
Well, that's the strangest thing. I just must go see that poor boy. What a poor little thing. What's the matter?
No, 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 you don't.
Oh, this is a terrible day.
Fran!
This is a miserable day that's fallen upon us. Yes.
Fran, what happened?
Miss Coocoo is back.
Who?
Miss Coocoo.
No.
Yes, and she's seen Ollie, and Ollie has seen her.
Fletcher, wherever did you get that clock?
Oh, really, I didn't know. My lecture's over for today.
Fletcher, you don't know what you've done. Oh, stop
it, there
it
goes again.
No more, no more. Here.
Oh, Kukla, what shall we do?
Poor Miss Coocoo.
Well, poor Ollie.
Remember how she chased him around last year?
Oh, yes. It took him 6 months to get to be his... Here he was a new him yesterday. Now it's the old him. Oh, it's awful.
I feel pretty bad about it.
Well, I do, too. I don't think...
It isn't that I don't like Miss Coocoo. She's a charming bird. But
she's a bird, all right. I'll say that. Well, it's everybody to his own opinion, I always say.
I always say that, too.
You get tired of saying it?
Yes.
Me, too.
Me, too. Well...
You better...
I didn't know what time it was, but I do now. I'll stay close to you. Protect me, kids.
That we shall.
We'll do our best, Ollie. Well, are you too tired to say...
No, I'm not. Remember, in television...
It's RCA!
Victor.
Hello, this is Bert Tilstrom, thanking you very kindly on behalf of my little friend, Mercedes, who might say, if she were asked...
Thank you. Thank you very much.
RCA Victor, world leader in radio, first in recorded music, first in television. Kukla, Fran, and Ollie came to you from Chicago.